throughout this world. Horses built the world, they built America. Without the horses, the history of this entire world would be something totally different. And we can go back to breeds, and go back to the Icelandic horses, to the fjords, to all of these breeds, and they all have a history in developing these countries and developing the world as we know it today. And if we have a story now that we'd like to tell you with some of these equine legends, and it's quite a story, and we're really happy to have this group of young people here to tell you this story. Frankly, you know, there are a group of teenagers who came up with this idea on their own. They staged it, and they've done all this work themselves. So we're very proud to bring to you tonight a trip with the Equine Legends.
Once upon a time, when Vikings ruled the seas and strange creatures roamed the land, there was an island with no name. This island was divided by nature's greatest forces, fire and ice, two opposites from the beginning of time. For years, fire sprites and ice nymphs have lived in peace. Then, a spirit of trickery and chaos was born out of the mist. Born for fire and ice cream. Her name was Slayout. She whispered in dreams that the island should have a name, and then she basked in the chaos that it brought. The gods Thoth and Eldura fought over what to name the island. Fire and ice struggled valiantly for the right to name their home. Volcanoes erupted, and ice storms rolled across the land. Fire riders from steeds of flame, and ice cavalry. They charge with bolts of frost.
competition. First archer, ready, go!
Upon your coming of age, it is tradition.
Father, I will. Just stop rushing me.
I'm sorry. Choose wisely. We must enter our best warrior in as good a challenge. Our water clan will win again.
If you had let me compete last year, I would have sent that loser cascading back to his mom.
The top two archers will move on to the last competition. The moving target challenge.
Thank you. How do you like those equine legends? Thank you. I want you to remember that this was conceived and put together by this group of teenagers, Evan being the mastermind. The choreographer by his 12-year-old sister, Delaney. And all of these great kids did all of this, props and the like, all themselves. And I want to give a special thanks to Chris, John, Terry, Monique, Ann, Linda, and Ed. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time for the Equine Legends. Those kids put on a wonderful show.